Look at that.
Once again, dude. This video still brings back a lot of bad memories. Still love it though, and same with the song. So familiar, isn't it? So my synopsis the second time around is this back. Didn't pay a single cent for this either. Yep. I did get sound drivers installed. I just went to their website and downloaded it. It worked fine. Same with video drivers. And it's playing fine. This video is not the greatest example since it's in slow-mo right now, but I'm gonna turn it off right now. And I mean, here's this good thing. Look, oh, there you go. If I bring it down to where it used to be, look. And that's pretty good. I'm just gonna close it. I'm not gonna go back to it this time around because I have other stuff to show and I'd rather it not hamper my performance, but yeah, there is my desktop, which should be familiar. If you go back to some of my older videos, you'll see the basically the exact same thing. You got all my
Half-Life stuff. I installed it all there,
and it works great. It's very smooth. I mean, show you guys here, man. Once again, dude. It's again. Really nice and smooth. Not really easy to tell on video, but no, it's really good. It's really good. When compared to here, let's open up the same control panel. And I'm gonna keep this here as a desktop. This is mainly like gonna be my setup right there. You got that, and then you got that. Of course, I have to set that up all the time, and I have other stuff on there most times, but in comparison, so that's a lot slower. But yeah, you can see right there. That's specs, gig of RAM, got a 1.83 gigahertz Pentium 4, I believe, processor. XP, Service Pack 3. But no. Yeah, I've got all my games installed. Whoops. never mind that. Got all my stuff installed, though. Okay, I'll continue the video. Anyway, I got Fraps there. Hopefully that'll work better now than it used to. It got QuickTime and iTunes and everything installed. Got Office. Once again, I was able to activate it, no problem. Same thing, just called them and they gave me the numbers. They were different numbers this time. I also installed, and this is an interesting one. You got Battlefront 1 for PC. Back in the day, this game would either not launch on the... This is on the Latitude, same thing. I haven't upgraded it at all, besides changing out the hard drive. It used to blue screen and then just sometimes not launch because of the video card or whatever. It's an NVIDIA one, but actually now it works perfectly fine. I had to tone it down to medium to get it to run at a decent level. It's weird. Sometimes it'll run at like 60 frames, be buttery smooth. In other areas, it'll be choppy. So I'll have to see. Of course, Valve right there. Got Civilization 3 complete. Got Condition Zero. Half-Life 2, Collector's Edition, Sierra right there. Oh yeah, look at that, that's Half-Life collecting right there. But yeah, I thought I'd show this off, because I mentioned in one of my older room tour videos that Half-Life 2 would run on these well. It actually does, but not for me back then. Back in those days, like, for example, we can just say the map Office in Counter-Strike Source, the second you turned around or went outside, it would be laggy. That was just on a 60 gig hard drive. I don't know if it's if there was bloatware on the system, or what, or if it was just this little hard drive causing problems, or the low space hard drive rather. But now I'll just do dust just to show off. But yeah, sorry about the shaking. It's just I'm holding an iPad right now and it's not easy to do. But yeah, because this used to be my sister's before me, and she had, like, uTorrent, and she torrented music for a while there, so I'm afraid that it had, like, malware or something on it, and that was why it was slow. But on here, it works fine. I mean, it works great. It says 1.6 there for some reason. I don't know. But yeah, if you go to... Looks great, man. I also put bots on, and the slowdown is certainly noticeable with bots. Sorry about the control here, I'm doing that, but yeah, I mean, it works very well. Very, very well. Better than I ever got to work on even the Pavilion X360, but yeah, and this is on max settings. There you go, resolution. Max settings right there. Yes, and it's great. If you add bots, the slowdown is noticeable. It's still playable, but there is slowdown, certainly. But, yep. And I used to have problems. You can actually see my comment on the guy I got this from. I think it's either XJR or JXR. 9000 on YouTube. He did the Half-Life 2004 experience or whatever. And he did a video showing how to download a standalone non-Steam version of the Half-Life 2 Collector's Edition, which is what I have right here. Before, whenever you, in Half-Life 2 and Source, whenever you would reach a loading point, the game would crash and say that whatever random number combination referenced memory at another random memory combination, the memory could not be read. Doesn't happen anymore. And, show you guys, Team Fortress. Here, got bots installed and everything. I mean, freaking smooth, too. But yeah, and I can install my... The only thing I have not installed on this yet is the software for my capture card, the EasyCap. Which I'm going to do, then I can actually film that I can film the Battlefront 2 video. Even though the footage itself is filmed, I just don't have it on my computer yet. Let's do Hunted again, because that's what we did last time. But no, it works great. I mean, I'm happy with it. I'm really happy with it. And of course, having a near 300 gig hard drive is really nice, because I'm at like 270 left. By the time I really started to make my Half-Life videos, I had like 6 gig free. So, I'm showing you guys that it works. Assassins. It's crazy. Add bots. Add bot. Bill Fox, Bill Gates. Just throw some guys in. The Reaper, unfortunately. The Reaper is not one of the players in this version, but yeah. Good enough. You can see the speed is fine and the frame rate's great, so. It's hard to control like this. Hey, friend. Yeah. See, I'm pretty good. But no, it works great. I mean, it's awesome. Someday, I said, a sloth. There you go. That's neat. I still run it in software mode, because that's the fastest for me. Crap. Resume game, whatever. It's good enough. You don't need to tell me. That, hold on. I can't close it. Quit. There we go. That was the one. It's okay. Civilization 4 runs well. It used to run kind of laggy. Battlefield 1942 used to run kind of laggy. I'd assume it works now. Same with Day of Defeat. I actually installed the wrong version. I installed Beta 1 rather than Retail. Because actually, I never said this, but this disc does not work. I could not get it to install. The disc was too damaged. It doesn't have any obvious damage, but yeah, it was too damaged to install. So yeah, this will just be my main, like, it'll just be my desktop, really, and then this is my laptop and my gaming computer. But, yep. Pretty cool, huh? never thought I'd really see this again, but... I mean, there's the one swap thing right there. That's good. Still don't have the Intellivision subassembly service manual. I think it's funny, that stayed on my, because this is, that was the Ben account I had for the whole time I had this freaking computer, besides at the end I went to Workspace. Which I have not linked on this yet. I will make that account soon. And make it the way I wanted a long time ago. I'll fulfill what I wanted with Workspace. But, still, The things that remained on my desktop, my old YouTube vids and the Intellivision subassembly service manual, those two items remained on my desktop from late 2015, like October, beginning of October, till it died. And I guess they will return soon when I can find that subassembly service manual, and I just haven't taken the time to copy the YouTube vids. So. Yep, it's coming along. It's coming along. And... Oh, you know what? You want to see something good? I'm also just trying to make sure. Here. Oh, whatever. That's okay. I didn't have it. I still have some stuff on flash drives that I haven't copied yet. I thought I had a thing on here. That's fine. Whatever. But no, yeah, it works great. So, I'm happy with it. And it's just cool to see that again. So, yeah, it works great. I've been making daily videos recently. My days feel a lot longer now than they used to. So, it doesn't seem like it's been that long to me. So, we'll have to see if I can keep that up. Probably not. I'll probably go back to uploading like once every 2 weeks, but we'll have to see. Also, there's 1942. You haven't seen these in a while. There's my Battlefront 1 for PC with the cracked case right there. They're completely DRM-free, Civilization 4. Also, I haven't put my music on there yet, but I'll do that soon. Alright, I'm gonna leave the video off there, so catch you guys later, and there you go. Both run on XP, so... I don't have any other computers, so I'm an XP-only user right now, unless I would've swapped or put the Linux hard drive back in there. I can do that whenever I want it, but... Yep. Catch you guys later. Oh, real quick, flip camera doesn't work with it either, so I can't, and I don't want to spend the time, so I'm still going to film on the iPad for now, unless I can buy a new flip or find something else that works like that, but, yep, catch you guys later.